Good morning. Welcome to Sacred Heart Cathedral. We gather this morning to celebrate the third Sunday of Easter and in honor of Cardinal Rigali's 80th birthday on the occasion of the cathedral groundbreaking. Please stand and join in singing our opening hymn, Lift High the Cross.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
I just want to welcome all of you as we gather together in this very historic moment in the history of the Diocese of Knoxville, the Catholic Church in East Tennessee, with friends of the Cardinal and friends of the diocese from around the United States. But in a very special way, I'd like to welcome His Eminence William Cardinal Levada, the Prefect Emeritus of the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith, and a dear friend of Cardinal Rigali and Cardinal Timothy Dolan, a fellow St. Louis Cardinal fan from the Archdiocese of New York, and my brother bishops who join with us today as we praise our God and as we celebrate the faith that has been given to us by Jesus Christ. We invoke the intercession of the Blessed Mother, our patroness, and our co-patron, St. John Paul II. And so as we gather together, we just praise God for the gift of faith and the gift of His love.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope
to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witness. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did, but God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of the prophet, that is, Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Escúchame cuando te invoco, Dios defensor mío. Tú que en el aprieto me diste anchura, ten piedad de mí y escucha mi oración. Wonders for his faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him. O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart. Christo, I en seguida me duermo, porque tu solo, Señor, me haces vivir tranquilo.
Lectura de la primera carta de San Juan. Hijitos míos, les escribo esto para que no pequen. Pero si alguien peca, tenemos como intercesor ante el Padre a Jesucristo el justo. Porque Él se ofreció como víctima de expiación por nuestros pecados, y no solo por los nuestros, sino por los del mundo entero. En esto tenemos una prueba de que conocemos a Dios, en que cumplimos sus mandamientos. Quien dice, yo lo conozco, pero no cumple sus mandamientos, es un mentiroso y la verdad no está en él. Pero en aquel que cumple su palabra, el amor de Dios ha llegado a su plenitud, y precisamente en esto conocemos que estamos unidos a él. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos,
Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The
the two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus, it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends in Christ, it was just over a year and a half ago, in September 2013, that the people of God of the Diocese of Knoxville, together with visitors and friends, gathered together with Bishop Stika for a great celebration. It was the Eucharistic Congress being held to commemorate the 25th anniversary of this local church in East Tennessee. Today, we gather once again for another important celebration in the life of this diocese of Knoxville. It is our Eucharistic liturgy. It is our Eucharistic liturgy followed by the groundbreaking ceremony for a new cathedral dedicated to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. It is a joy for the people of God of this Diocese of Knoxville to know that at this very special moment, they are surrounded and supported by many visitors and friends whose solidarity means so much to them. In the name of Bishop Stika, who has given me the privilege to offer this Mass, I repeat his own warm welcome to the cardinals and bishops who have come for this celebration today. A special greeting goes to Cardinal William Levada, Prefect Emeritus of the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith in Rome, and to Cardinal Timothy Dolan, Archbishop of New York. We are likewise greatly honored by the presence of Bishop David Chobe, Bishop of Nashville, the church from which the Diocese of Knoxville was originally formed. Bishop Roger Foys, Bishop of Covington, Bishop John Gados, Bishop of Jefferson City, Bishop Michael Sheridan, Bishop of Colorado Springs, Bishop Joseph Bambera, Bishop of Scranton, Bishop Herbert Bavard, Bishop of St. Thomas, Virgin Islands, and Bishop Michael Fitzgerald, Auxiliary Bishop of Philadelphia. Their presence, together with that of so many lay faithful who have come a great distance to be here, shows the beautiful communion of the Catholic Church throughout our country and beyond, under our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Bishop of Rome. The Eucharistic celebration today, with the groundbreaking for a new cathedral for Knoxville, tells us a great deal about the meaning of the church. We are reminded that Christ's church, which St. Paul calls the body of Christ, is a community united by faith and baptism with Jesus Christ himself. Every church building, every parish church, is an image of an even greater spiritual structure, which is the living community of God's people. And every cathedral is built to be the mother church of a particular diocese, the principal church where the faithful from all the different parishes come together with their bishop to pray. The external cathedral structure bears witness to the internal unity of all the faithful of the local church who are called to be one in Christ Jesus. From every part of the diocese, the faithful are invited to assemble with their bishop to listen to the proclamation of God's holy word and to partake in the Eucharistic sacrifice of Jesus, which is the supreme sacramental proclamation of the gospel. The cathedral, as the seat of the bishop and his ministry, becomes the sign of the whole evangelizing mission of the church, the sign of all the loving service rendered throughout the diocese by the people of God to those in need. It is the cathedral. It is the principal place where the word of God is proclaimed, where the teaching of the church is communicated, and where priests are ordained, and from where they are sent forth to proclaim Jesus Christ to all who will freely listen to their voice. The cathedral is the perpetual reminder of the universal dimension of the local church, in which individual parish communities reach out, look beyond themselves, and joyfully find the fulfillment and enrichment of their own unity in Christ. All of this explains, dear friends, why we assemble today in the context of our Eucharist to ask God's blessings on this important endeavor about to take place, the groundbreaking of a new cathedral that evokes the love of the Sacred Heart of Jesus for his people and will serve for years to come as the Mother Church in East Tennessee. As this cathedral rises, by the grace of God, it will also tell the story of the faith and generosity and sacrifice of the people of God of this diocese, as well as the charity and solidarity of friends and benefactors who offer vital assistance to Bishop Stika and to the Diocese of Knoxville in this sacred endeavor to build a worthy temple for the glory of God. With this hope and challenge, we draw inspiration today in this sacred liturgy from God's holy word that we have just heard on this third Sunday of Easter. You know, the church draws great strength and power listening to the proclamation of Christ's Paschal mystery, hearing St. Peter in the Acts of the Apostles tell the people, "The author of life," he said, "you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." And today, in today's gospel, we hear that Jesus himself, on the road to Emmaus, opened the minds of his disciples to understand the scriptures when he personally explained to the disciples that Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all nations. As we prepare for the groundbreaking and eagerly await the day of the new cathedral here in Knoxville, we can only wonder how many minds the Lord Jesus will open in the new edifice to understand and accept the Word of God, which is this precious treasure given to us. The new cathedral will clearly be the house of God and of his word for all the people. The new cathedral will also be the place where, in the expression of our responsorial psalm, the Lord will let his face shine on us and put gladness into our hearts. Here, in the new cathedral, the whole diocesan community of priests, women and men religious, seminarians and laity, with all our families, will be at home in their Father's house. Here, in the Word of God and the sacraments of his church, they will encounter Jesus Christ and his message of mercy and truth. Here in the new cathedral, the art and music of our Christian traditions will be available also to other fellow Christians and to all people of goodwill. The edifice itself will express with dignity the primacy of God in our society. It will convey his command of charity and be a witness of fellowship and hospitality in East Tennessee. Dear friends, with sentiments of joy, we listen once again and repeat the words of our responsorial psalm. Lord, let your face shine upon us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, substantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord is truly risen and lives to intercede for us. In Easter joy, let us pray for our needs and the needs of all our brothers and sisters throughout the world.
For the church, that we may be renewed in holiness and love every time we gather together to read the scriptures and break the bread, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
لجميع المسيحيين المضطهدين الذين يعانون على أيدي أسوأ ما في البشر لتكون يد الرب عليهم لتكون يد الرب عليهم وليختبروا نعمته أقوى من أي وقت مضى. باركهم يا رب ببركاتك. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Sa mga bagong binyagan, nawa sila'y maging masigasig sa adhikaing kanilang pinili, na tumuon sa Panginoon sa hirap at ginhawa, manalangin tayo sa Panginoon.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Que a través de la gracia de Dios, la libertad religiosa y el respeto de los derechos de la conciencia prevalezcan, roguemos al Señor.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Cầu cho tất cả chúng ta, xin cho con mắt chúng ta được rộng mở, để thấy được sự hiện diện của Chúa trong những người xung quanh. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Tuwaombe marehemu wetu wapate kupumzika kwa amani na kushiriki katika ufalme wa mbinguni. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer. Be with us, Lord, as our companion on life's way. Help us to recognize your presence among us in the scriptures and in the breaking of bread, and set our hearts on fire with love, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Please join in singing our offertory hymn, Pescador de Hombres.
Ave Maria,
Descanse, amor que quiero.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices for today. Praise the Lord in this name. For our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
En verdad es justo y necesario, es nuestro deber y salvación, glorificarte siempre, Señor. Pero más que nunca en este tiempo en que Cristo, nuestra Pascua, fue inmolado. Por él los hijos de la luz nacen a la vida eterna y las puertas de los cielos han vuelto a abrirse para los que creen en él. Ya que en su muerte murió nuestra muerte, y en su gloriosa resurrección hemos resucitado todos. Por eso, con esta efusión de gozo pascual, el mundo entero se desborda de alegría, y también los coros celestiales, los ángeles y los arcángeles cantan sin cesar el himno de tu gloria. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, and with Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John Paul, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, Justin, here present, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God. power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Daos fraternalmente la paz. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. I kind of like this experience. I just sit here and watch everything go on. First of all, to all of you, I hope you understand the historic moment in the life of this diocese. That's why, in a very special way, it's good to have my friend Bishop Chobe from the Diocese of Nashville. I call him the Patriarch of the South, because he's a true Southern gentleman. Nashville is the mother diocese of the state of Tennessee. It was the only diocese until 1971, when the Diocese of Memphis was created at the invitation of Elvis Presley. And just in 1988, St. John Paul created this wonderful diocese, and I have the honor and the privilege of serving as the third bishop of this diocese, and it is a wonderful place. For in so many ways, I see the Spirit of Jesus acting in the lives of people, in small parishes and large parishes, and how people volunteer in the volunteer state. I really do see faith alive, faith shared, and God loved through the power of Jesus and the gift of his Holy Spirit. And so in a very special way, I want to thank my brother bishops who are here today. Some have traveled farther than others. Other bishops wanted to be here, but this is confirmation season. So in June at our bishops meeting, this year it'll actually be in St. Louis, a number of the bishops are going to get together to celebrate what we do today, celebrating the 80th birthday of Cardinal Rigali. So we look forward to that. And to the cathedral staff, you know, this day has been a long time in coming. I remember talking to Bishop O'Connell, the founding bishop of this diocese, and he was telling me that at the beginning there were many people who said, we need to build a cathedral. And he said, no, we have to build a diocese. 10, 12 years ago, it came up again about building a cathedral. We had to nourish the diocese. But at this moment in our history, we are nourishing the diocese, we are building the diocese, we are Christ to others, and it's time now, because the growth of this parish, but also the growth of the diocese, to build a mother church. And so that's what we do this day as we begin breaking ground. And so to the cathedral staff, and especially to Father David, who's been taking the leadership in this, I just want to express my thanks. You know, sometimes he disappears, and I say, where you been? Oh, I was fundraising in Tahiti. See? But I want to thank him and the staff here and the choir today, and in a special way, all of you. And my brother priests are here, and friends of the Cardinal. You know, I've known Cardinal Rigali since, the first time I talked to him was January of 1994, when I got a phone call from Rome informing me that I was to be his secretary, his assistant. And then when I met him that March day, coming off the plane at Lambert International in St. Louis, the journey began that takes us to this very moment. I've learned so much from the Cardinal. I learned that pasta is good. I've been able to experience so much with the Cardinal, from our trip to Bolivia, to Africa, to Lebanon, to different places in Europe. And now both of us have traveled to the beauty of East Tennessee. Who would have thought that, Eminence, in 1994? It took him a week. He kept on saying to me, now what's your name again? We have many of his friends scattered from different places in the United States, and the Virgin, or the Bahamas, where are you from? Virgin Islands, or? I get it all confused. Father Herbie Brevard, who was a bishop in Philadelphia, now is in the Caribbean. So he invites all of you to come down and he'll take care of you. But I've known the Cardinal all these years, and I've seen the best of him always, a true man of the church. So much so that when he was ordained a bishop by St. John Paul II, didn't he at one time refer to you as my brother Justin? Mm-hmm. You got to answer the question.
Yes.
See, he yes. did. And so, in the name of all of the people who gather together this day, Eminence, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Also, I owe him a great debt of gratitude. For 3 weeks ago, if he was not in the house, I would be in some meat freezer somewhere waiting for eternity. So I just want to thank the Cardinal for saving my life those 3 weeks ago, and for all of you and for your prayers. And for all those people who are over in the gym, I can't see you, but you're very much a part of the celebration. And those who are watching this on the internet, I hope you're not eating lunch during Mass. I'm watching you. So again, this is history, and let us celebrate it with great joy and great thanksgiving to Almighty God, for he has given us the precious gift of Jesus, what we have just celebrated here, and he empowers us with the Holy Spirit to not be afraid and go forward in the history of this local church surrounded by the beauty of East Tennessee. And I give you Father David, the rector of the cathedral.
Thank you, Bishop. Just a few instructions about how we're going to leave church to go outside for the blessing of the new site and the blessing of the cornerstone. For those of you who are challenged with mobility, you can either stay on the back porch to overlook the blessing site, or you can come out the side door here underneath the canopy of the front of the school and stay in that area. The sound will be projecting up in both areas. For everyone who's interested in walking down the hill, after the procession passes your row, if you'll fall in line behind the procession and just follow the Knights and Ladies of the Holy Sepulchre out the front of the church and down the pavement to the area where we're going to have the blessing. Those who are going to be assisting with shovels, there's a special area marked for you, as well as for our building committee off the right side of the stage. And we just invite everyone to come down and join together as we begin to make history today.
And I also forgot to acknowledge the presence of two cardinals. They're over here in the corner. Cardinal William Levada, former Prefect Emeritus of the Congregation for Doctrine of the Faith, a big shot. So highly respected is the Cardinal that when Cardinal Ratzinger was elected Pope Benedict, it was the Holy Father that chose Cardinal Levada to take his place as prefect. And so, like I said, he's a big shot in the church. And then we have Cardinal Dolan, who's a dear friend of mine, and especially of the Cardinal. He and I share something very special. Both of us were ordained bishops by Cardinal Rigali, and so that's a wonderful experience. I must admit, though, I've been thinking about this. I'm going to make a major announcement that I've been reflecting on. Yesterday, for those of you who were at the conversation with the Cardinals, 1,100-plus, Cardinal Dolan made this wonderful statement. He said that if the Mets win the World Series, he would make a sizable donation to our cathedral fund. So I prayed and reflected, and I looked at the great photos of Stan Musial at home. I'm going to root for the Mets this year. So every time you pray, this is a mandate from the Bishop of the Diocese of Knoxville. Jesus, I trust in you. And I think we got to get nice weather outside. Is it raining? Can you look? Who cares? We'll go outside anyway. All right, Eminence, it's all yours.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Odeisi et in paz. Go forth in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Please join in singing our recessional hymn, To Jesus Christ, Our Sovereign King.